And John, I frankly didn't think we were going to have a very good football game tonight before we came out here. Matter of fact, I haven't been up mentally all day long for this contest. It's going to be kind of a ho-hum affair. But boy, this has turned into a real dandy, and Rigby's made it that way. And of course, Idaho Falls has now made it by that way by coming back here following the 11-point deficit.
So Monk to tee it up back deep again. It's Yearsley standing at his own 10-yard line, but on every kickoff so far tonight, Monk has done the squib kick, and let's see if he does it again with 36 seconds, and he does. It's going to be bounced up to the up back at the 22. That is Jake Erickson. Erickson returns it to the 34 for a return of 12. Tackle made by Jake Flippen. So Rigby, first and 10 at the 34-yard line, just 32 seconds to go until halftime. Rigby leads 18-15.
And you have to think that Rigby's going to play it a little bit cozy now. Last time they had a little over 3 minutes to play when they took possession of the football, and so they did go for the touchdown scoring drive. But this time you kind of think that Ty Shippen is going to give the ball to one of his running backs, either Kazir or Peterson or Thomas, and the Trojans will go into the dressing room with a three-point lead. That's maybe. Peterson and Kazir are the running backs. They line up in the close set, and Shippen does hand the ball off to Kazir, who has a little bit of room, but then it breaks down real fast after about a one-yard gain. Jake Pippen, a nice diving ankle-type tackle to stop Kazir from going no further, and that's the end of the first half. It falls 15. Stick around. We'll be back with a halftime recap and a lot of other things you might want to hear right after this.
Six of them have been for over 10 yards, 15, 11, 42.
2 yards, 17-11, and the big 49-yard touchdown play. It's been Rigby with the big plays, and the Tigers will get the football to start this second half.
And before the second half occurs, let's give you another score. Hillcrest in the first quarter is leading Pocatello by a 7-0 score in the first game of that doubleheader. Highland demolished Bonneville 46-6, and Skyline clings to that 7-0 lead over Madison. Keep in mind, Madison scored 51 points against the same Rigby team last week. Tonight, Skyline's defense shutting them out.
No surprise, though, the Skyline D, an exceptional bunch of kids. Jake Erickson teams it up for Rigby back deep. Kevin Tenike, Jake Pippen, and I believe that Kent to identify the third player. It might be Pat Owens, but no Scott Warren. Here's the kick. It's a high kick. It's going to be flipping at the 15-yard line. He's to the 20, 25, and he's tripped up at the 30 and fights his way up. Also, Tyler Wright.
That's Tom St. Clair gets the start.
Big key offensive series as we begin the third quarter for the Tigers. Line of scrimmage, the 33. Lee fakes the handoff, rolls to the far side, has room. Lee gets a block from Hammond. He has the first down near midfield. And finally brought down by Hellman Hancock. Brady Lee has just run for 14 yards. So Lee, on the first play from scrimmage, goes for 14. From the 33 to the 47, Tigers pick up first down number 11. Ball at the Idaho Falls 47.
And that's something the Tigers didn't do a lot in the first half, and that is use that added dimension, the running ability of Brady Lee. They did that time to perfection, and maybe that's going to be the plan here in the third quarter.
High formation. Tigers hand the ball to Tenike up the middle inside Rigby territory down to the 48 for a gain of 5. Ryan Hershey, nose guard, made the stop. Along with Denton Anderson. A gain of 4. It'll be second down and 6 for Idaho Falls. Ball at the Rigby 49-yard line. As Jim mentioned, Hillcrest leading Pocatello 7-0 down in the dome. Big game for the Knights. They're 4-0, but they haven't had much competition as of yet, and a real task for Randy Gleave and his undefeated Knights. First lead wide left of the near side. It's Nate Hammond. Tigers trying to regain the lead. They trail it by 3. Lee takes the handoff, rolls to the near side, throws downfield to Hammond. It's knocked away by Hellman Hancock at the last minute. Nate Hammond had a couple of steps on Hancock, but the pass was a bit underthrown. That allowed Hancock, the Trojan free safety, to come over and knock it away. It'll be third down and 6. And now it's third down and 6 for the Tigers. Ball at the Rigby 49. Big play for the Tiger offense. Tigers will send trips to the near side. That's trips wide as Idaho Falls moving the ball from left to right or south to north. He rolls to the near side. He has room. He's going to have the first and 10. He's inside the 40. Knocked out of bounds by Hancock at the 39. That'll be a gain of 10 for Brady Lee of the Tigers. So Brady Lee comes out, rushes for 14 and for 10. The junior quarterback picks up a big first down that time. Tigers have a first and 10 at the Trojan 39.
Well, you like to see it all happen. Brady Lee doing the things that he is doing. On the other hand, it's a little bit scary. Boy, Brady was really wrapped around that time as he was brought down.
Straight quarterback keeper that time. Tigers send trips to the right, and Lee rolled to his right and had the blocking out in front. This time the Tigers send trips left, lone setback. It's Ellison. Lee hands the ball to Mark Ellison on the misdirection. Ellison hurdles a would-be tackle, picks up 5. Jesse Thomas finally made this Tigers. First possession of the second half. Idaho Falls trying to read period. Again, the Tigers send trips left. This time it's Klein in the slot to the left, and Tenike is the lone setback. Tight end Martin is strong right. Here's the quick pitch to Tenike. Tenike is inside the 35, going to be brought down by Garrett Smith. Great play, Garrett Smith, with his free safety position. No gain, make it a gain of 1. It'll be third down and a long 4, a short 5. Take your pick, but the Tigers will need to come up with another third down conversion to keep this drive. And again, it's trips to the near side. Tenike in the slot, the lone setback. Ellison on 3rd and 5. Lee rolls to the near side, has blocker out in front. Lee's going to cut it upfield. He's hit. He's going to find his way inside the 30, down to the 29, close to the 1st and 10. Ryan Taylor, the strong side backer, made the stop, and Brady Lee again picks up the big first down on a 3rd third down play. So Brady Lee doing it with his legs instead of his right arm here in the third quarter, and the Tiger drive is alive.
Well, Brady Lee saw three tacklers in front of him about 2 yards shy of the first down yardage, and you know what he did? He knew he was going to go down, so he said, I'm going to get all I can. He got his head as low as he could to the turf and dove forward, and he did get the first down by about a foot.
Line of scrimmage, the Trojan 29-yard line. This time, Jack Klein in motion. Lee, the lone man in the backfield. Brady Lee on the quarterback keeper. Good move. Lee inside the 25, down to the 22 for a gain of 7. Brian Hershey, the nose tackle, along with Jeff Peterson, the inside backer, in on the stop.
I can say Brady Lee made a heck of a play, though, as he eluded the tackle of Jeff Peterson. Although Peterson did slow him up, he didn't stop him behind the line of scrimmage, and it did take Hershey to bring him down following the pickup of 7.
Brady Lee has rushed for 14, 10, 6, and 7 here in the third quarter on this drive. Second down and 3. A long 3, a short 4. Take your pick. Ellison is the lone setback. Blue Brady Lee, 3-step drop. Rifles one down, but it's deflected at the line of scrimmage by Jeremy Majera, the defensive end. It'll be 3rd and 3.
Brady
pass
Lee
intended for Hursley.
Brady Lee, 6 completions, 14 attempts, 111 yards, 2 touchdowns. He's had a good night upstairs. Now he's getting it done downstairs.
8 carries, 56 yards for the junior quarterback. Big third down play coming up. The Tigers have cashed in on a couple of third down conversions on this drive. This time the Tigers come out in the I set. Jack Klein and Kevin Tenneich, the running backs. Right up the middle, it's Tenneich. Tenneich has the first down. He's inside the 15, tackled at the 14 for a gain of 9. Tackle made by Hershey and Majera. And again, number 72. We cannot identify the Trojan wearing number 72, not on our roster. But Tenneich picked up 9. And the Tigers again with a third down conversion. That's the 3rd straight on this drive.
And their 14th first down of this game, the 4th of the half.
1st and 10 from the Trojan 14. 7:35 to go in the third quarter. A time-consuming drive for the Tigers. This drive started at the Tiger 33. Lee hands the ball to Tenneich. Sweeps the right side. Cuts inside. Great play by Jesse Thomas. And now a flag is thrown way away from the action.
And Jesse Thomas threw Mark Ellison right into Tenneich. And that's why the game there wasn't anymore.
The penalty, blocking below the knees against Idaho Falls. Thomas shed the blocker and brought down Tenneich all in the same motion. Great play by the senior inside backer. The penalty will go against the Tiger offense. The flag thrown at the line of scrimmage, which was the 14. It'll be a 15-yard mark-off back to the 31, make it the 29-yard line. The Tigers have 1st and 25 for Idaho Falls' 5th penalty, 55 yards against the orange and black, as Jack Klein gets a play from his father and brings it into the Tiger huddle. Rigby 18, Idaho Falls 15. 1st and 25. Tigers have to take it down to the Rigby 4, the line of scrimmage, the 29. Lee up under center Charter. Lee back to pass, has time, wants to go deep. Nate Hammond is down there. It's going to be nearly picked off, and a flag is thrown. Pass interference, but the question is, it defensive interference or offensive interference? It was Yearsley and Hammond fighting for the football.
Well, they were both going for the football simultaneously, and almost was shocked to see a flag thrown there because they were both going for the ball. And now one official comes over, and you know, this one could be waved off because both of them are going for the ball.
The huddle is at the 3-yard line where the flag was thrown.
Although the official closest to the play threw the flag, and so it probably should stand on whichever team it's against.
Well, 4 of the 5 Zebras are huddling up at the 3-yard line talking things over. Pass interference, offense. So it'll go against the Tigers. If Rigby refuses, it'll bring up 2nd down and 25. Was it picked off? Perhaps Rigby came up with the interception. The Rigby offense comes on the turf, but hold on, let's wait and see.
Well, Gillsley got in front of the intended receiver of Idaho Falls. I didn't see the ball get picked off, but he did get in front, and I guess he did make Tiger intended receiver also making an attempt to catch the ball. but they rule it pass interference even though the interception was made, and Rigby takes over first down at their own 1 foot line.
So the Tigers turn it over for the first time tonight. It's a costly turnover. Idaho Falls trying to score to go ahead. Instead, Rigby takes over 99 yards away from the goal line.
And maybe the Tigers got a little bit of a break right there in Rigby intercepting the pass. They maybe would have been better off by taking the 15-yard penalty again for offensive pass interference and keeping the ball with the Tigers, but we'll see. Here's a quarterback sneak by Shippen, and he moves forward for about 2 yards. And he gets it up to about the 2 or 3 yard line, and will bring up second down and 8 from the 3 yard line. Mark Ellison in on the play. Boy, I think the Tigers got a big break that time, because the Tigers already were looking at, I think, third and long, and it would have been third and much longer.
First and 25, if they took the penalty, Rigby would have been first and about 35, but it would have given the Tigers 3 more cracks at it.
Back to Joe Shippen. Here's the pass. It's thrown deep, and it's incomplete. And now they're going to call pass interference either against Brandon Andrews or Nate Hammond.
Great rush by Jake Phippen on Ty Shippen. Phippen hit Shippen in the backfield in the end zone, but I think this one is will be pass interference against Rigby. So one offensive interference against Idaho Falls, and on the next play, or the seconds of the next play, it returns the favor of the Trojans, penalized for pass interference.
Brandon Andrews was the intended receiver. The ball was in the air, and he collided going downfield with Nate Hammond. And they call offensive pass interference against Rigby.
And they call loss of down. It'll be third down instead of second down.
And the ball will be at the 3 yard line. And there are a few fans from Rigby who thought maybe that possibly could have been defensive pass interference.
A lot of fans from Rigby are calling that a makeup call.
Third and 9. Here's Shippen dropping straight back and throwing the ball very deep, and this one is incomplete. Again, that was Nate Hammond. So Idaho Falls, who I think got a big break from Rigby when Rigby refused the offensive pass interference. Now Rigby's going to punt from their end zone, and the Tigers are going to have magnificent field position, and it'll be a golden opportunity for Idaho Falls to go in front in this game.
Eric Kaderi will punt from the deepest stretch of the end zone, back deep. Nate Hammond, he stands at the Rigby 30, so the Tigers will get excellent field position. Good snap. Here comes the rush. Now it's going to be roughing the kicker penalty. Hammond takes the ball at the 30, but this is all for nothing as the Tigers have roughed the Trojan punter deep in the end zone. And boy, that's a big, big mistake.
28-yard kick, a return of about 4 yards. But boy, this is getting a little ugly out there now.
Boy, a big mental mistake by Idaho Falls. The Tigers would have had great field position, but instead it's a roughing the kicker or perhaps running into the kicker.
No questioning the call. The kicker was run into and was hit.
Just a mental error by the Tiger punt team.
Now, if it's just running into the kicker, is that automatic first down? That's the question. I think it is. I think it's going to be a 15-yard penalty.
Or maybe not. Here again, when you watch high school, college on Saturday, pros on Sunday, boy, the rules get all confused. There will be a 15-yard penalty, and Rigby will pick up a big first down.
Get your mind all discombobulated on how much each penalty should be, depending on what type of game we play.
That's the fourth 15-yard penalty marked off against the Tigers tonight.
6 minutes to go, third quarter. Rigby 18, and Idaho Falls 15. And now another flag is lined up in the neutral zone for Rigby, and so that'll cost the Trojans 5. Dead ball foul. Offsides against Rigby. So it'll be first and 15 for the Trojans. Somewhere along the line, we are going to get back with football.
Boy, a lot of yellow hankies have been thrown here in the last 2 minutes.
Incidentally, no fault of the officials there. There has been contact made. They're roughing the passer, and the receivers and defensive backs colliding, et cetera, et cetera. Flags had to be thrown. Here comes a pitchback. This is to Kazir turning the corner. Kazir got up across the 15, nearly got to the 20-yard line before Bowen made the tackle. Meanwhile, a flag two right behind the run. That would indicate a penalty against Rigby again. Or perhaps a clip or maybe a hole.
I believe that's 6 consecutive plays that a flag has been thrown.
Rigby has walking back, so whatever gain it was will be nullified. It was first and 15 from the 11 of Rigby. Now half the distance to the goal line would take it back to the 5.5, and it'll bring up first down, and I guess we will say 10.5. Whether first and 20 or 20.5. We'll just call it 20. Rigby out of the huddle. They are leading by 3. Idaho Falls defense with a golden opportunity if they can make a big play here of some kind. And here comes a handoff. They do make a big play. Kazir is tackled behind the line of scrimmage. And it was Ben Mason, the strong safety, and Pat Owens, outside linebacker, who did a heck of a job for the Bad Dog. He of the Tiger.
Owens made the initial hit. Kazir hurled over the arms of Owens, but then it was Ben Mason from the strong safety position. A loss of 3 back to the 3.
And you get the feeling that Idaho Falls defense is stiffened against the run that Rigby's going to have to throw if they're going to have any success at all against the Tigers. Meanwhile, the clock runs down, and there'll be less than 5 minutes to play in the third quarter when this play has gotten off. It's at the 3-yard line. It is second down, and now Rigby has some 23-24 to go for the first down. Shippen drops straight back. Now rolls to his right. Looks downfield. Throws short. Incomplete. Jordan Vaughn broke up the pass, I believe, intended for Brandon Andrews. It was. A little down and in pattern run by Andrews. It was broken up near the 12-yard line by Jordan Vaughn, and it'll bring up third and long for Rigby at their own 3-yard line.
For the intended receiver, Brandon Andrews, the ball and Jordan Vaughn arrived at the same time. Big hit by the Tiger free safety. It's third down.
And Shippen tonight is 8 for 12, 159 yards, one touchdown. Make it 8 for 13. He'll throw it again now. Shippen back to throw. Has decent protection. Now it's about to break down. Here's the pass, and he threw it away. Good pressure put on that time by Mike Jensen. Pass intended for Jeff DeBell, who was open, but I don't think Shippen even wanted to complete that pass to DeBell. So Rigby again is going to kick from the shadow of the goalpost, even though the sun is not out.
It'll be Eric Corderi hunting it from his end zone. And again, last time he did this, the Tigers roughed him, allowed the Trojans to keep the drive alive, but that drive resulted in negative yardage. It's been a crazy 3 or 4 minutes here in this third period.
Let's get this thing over with this third quarter.
Nate Hammond stands back at his 30. Good snap. It's a high kick, but not much distance. It's going to hit at the 15, take a Trojan roll, and it's going to roll down at the 26-yard line for a punt of 23 yards. So first and 10, Idaho Falls. Excellent field position for the Tigers to try to take the lead. Actually, line of scrimmage, the 25. So the punt traveled just 22 yards. No return. Tigers first and 10 from the Rigby 25. 4.5 to play in this third quarter. It is still Rigby 18, Idaho Falls 15. Tigers sent Hursley wide left to the near side. It's Hammond, Jack Klein, Kevin Tenike in the backfield. Snap by Fan Charter. Tenike gets the handoff. Tenike is hit by Jesse Thomas and Peterson along with Majera. Kevin picked up a tough 3 from the 25 down to the 22, third down 7.
And Kevin Tenike a little slow in getting up following the jarring tackle that was made on him. He is going to come out of the game.
And it's good news to see Scott Warren back in for the Tigers. Warren was injured in the second quarter. And now Scott Warren at the tailback slot. So that's good news for Idaho Falls fans.
One of the fastest runners, if not the fastest runner in Idaho Falls, Scott Warren.
Up front for the Tigers, Jensen, Wright, Charter, Longhurst, Nelson, and Martin. Second down, 7. Here's the handoff. Scott Warren has it. Kicks it outside, but a good tackle by Brian Taylor. The strong side backer, Scott Warren, gave Brian Taylor a ride for about 2 or 3 yards. Scott Warren picks up a tough 4. It'll be third down and 3. 3:45 to go in this third quarter. Call it third and 4 from the 18. 18.5-yard line. Nevertheless, Tigers will need to convert another. Defense is held. Third and 3. In motion, Nate Hammond. Here's the pitch. Kevin Tenike sweeps the right side, cuts it back inside. He's inside the 15, and he's going to be just close to the first and 10. I think he might have it. Pick up a 3. Tenike needed 3. And let's see if he got the needed yardage. He did. So Tenike picks up 3. The Tigers needed the 3, and the first down for Idaho Falls, their 15.
17 carries, 70 yards. Kevin Tenike, he was shaken up last time he carried the ball, but when he went back in, showed no signs of ill effects at all as he got the first down on his own, the 3 yards that he needed.
Tigers line up first and 10 at the Trojan 15-yard line. Tenike, the deep back in the split eye. Here's the handoff to Kevin. Kevin is going to be brought down by Hershey by the jersey for a loss of three. Nice play by Brian Hershey, the nose guard for the Trojans, a 200-pound senior. He's been all over the place for Rigby's D tonight. And the Tigers now face a 2nd-and-13 situation with 2.5 minutes to play in the third.
Somehow you get the feeling that 2-point conversion by Idaho Falls to pull the Tigers to within three of Rigby is going to loom big before this game is all over with.
Both wideouts, Hersley and Hammett, are wide to the left. Lee fakes the handoff, throws left, wants to throw out to Ellison, overthrows the fullback out of the backfield. Reed Conrad was covered up with the Trojans. If Ellison would have caught the football, I don't think he would have gotten much yardage because Conrad had it read for Rigby. It's 3rd-and-13. Clock stop, 2:19 to go, quarter number three. Rigby 18, Idaho Falls 15.
And Brady Lee just 1 for 7, 1 for his last 7, but that one completion that he made.
0-11 against Sam's Tigers, but they try to change all of that tonight. Lee back to pass. Sets up Ellison out in the flat. Ellison goes nowhere. A loss of two. It was, again, Reed Conrad and Brian Taylor in on the stop. Tigers wanted to set up a screen to Ellison out of the backfield. Collard the snapper, Hammond the holder, and, of course, Dave Bunk will try to tie this ball game up. For the snap. It's down. The placement is down. The kick by Monk is on its way, and it is. Hits the crossbar and bounces short. It is no good. 38-yard attempt, no good. If it would have been 37 yards, it would have been good, but it hit the crossbar, and the Tigers have been held scoreless again by the Rigby defense.
John indicated, had it been a 38-yard, a 37-yard field goal, it would have been good.
But it hit the crossbar and bounded back.
Now it's Rigby's ball, and Shippen is running the option around the left side, pitches back to Kazir, and Kazir just ran for five. On the left side, he was the third man in the option, and Tyler Kern came up and made the tackle. Up at the 25, we'll call it a gain of six on the play. It'll bring up 2nd-and-4. So Shippen faked to the dive man, Peterson, kept the ball himself, and pitched back. Rigby moving from right to left. The Trojans still lead by three. It's an 18-15 score. And here's the play again. A pitch back to Kazir. Blocker in front of him. Should get around the corner. Not quite. Ben Mason, a great play for the Tigers. And it prevented the first down. Kazir, as it turns out, only picked up two. So Rigby will look at the 3rd-and-2. They'll have the football at their own 27.
Great play, Ben Mason. Tigers strong safety. It appeared Kazir might have the corner, but Mason quickly came in, made the stop. It's a 3rd-and-2 play for Rigby.
Big play for the Tiger defense right here as they trail by three. This in all probability will be the final play of the third quarter. Clock is down to 15 seconds to go. It's 3rd-and-2 for Rigby. Shippen calls an audible. Waiting for the play. Here's the snap, and Shippen carries himself, and he didn't get the first down as Josh Mason and Aaron Nelson made superlative plays. In fact, the loss of a yard for Shippen, and so the Tiger defense has stiffened. They have stopped Rigby. It'll be 4th-and-about-2, and that's the end of the third quarter. 3:18:15, but Rigby is going to have to punt the football to Idaho Falls.
Eric Corderi will punt it from his 15-yard line of scrimmage. The 27 back deep for the Tigers, Nate Hammond. Scoreless third quarter, as was the case in the first quarter. Hammond's going to take it out of his 42. Oh, he let it drop. Did he touch it? I don't believe so. And it's going to be down at the Tiger 28, a 47-yard punt by Eric Corderi of Rigby. A good punt. Hammond came up at the 40. 42 as if he was going to catch it. At the last minute, shied away, and the Trojans on that decision picked up an additional 15 yards. First and 10, Idaho Falls from the Tiger 27-yard line. Update, Skyline late in the game leads Madison 13-6. Phil Fest and Pocatello tied at 7 down in the dome in Pocatello. Here it's Rigby 18, Idaho Falls 15. The Trojans trying to pull the upset here at Ranston Stadium. In motion, that's Nate Hammond. Brady Lee takes the snap, fakes the handoff. Lee wants to go deep. Downfield, it's Hammond. He cannot make the catch at the 40-yard line. Dillon and Hancock defensively for the Trojans. Well, knocked it away. And it's second down 10. Hammond nearly came up with a catch at the Trojan 40, but could not hold on. It'll be second and 10 out of Idaho Falls.
Almost a heck of a good catch by Nate Hammond, but a superlative defensive play by Hellman Hancock.
Everybody did everything right that time, Jeff. Win its first game ever against a Ken Sampson coach Tiger team. Split back formation this time on second and 10. Lee rolls to the near side. Brady Lee has time. Wants to go to Nate Hammond. And it's off Hammond's fingertips at the 50-yard line. And Hammond is down. A big hit again by Hellman Hancock, who's played a marvelous second half. Hammond is up. He's okay. Gets a swat of approval by Hancock, and the Tigers face third and 10.
Well, it went off his hands as you described, John, but the
third down 10. Man wearing his Y to the far side. And there's a Tigers go, I believe, double tight. Either that or they're a player short. Here's the throw, the snap to Lee. I believe the Tigers only had 10 men on the field. The throw downfield to Ellison. It's picked off by Micah Randall at midfield. The pass intended for Ellison, the flag on the play, and the Tigers will be the call for the penalty, and Rigby comes up with a big turnover at midfield. Brady Lee has been picked off by Mike. Been picked off two times.
And that was from minus 2 yards.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see if Rigby's going to try to eat up some clock. Peterson and Kazir in the backfield, and Peterson, Shipman carries, and Shipman is tackled by Tyler Kern for a loss of a yard. Back to the 48. Well, no question the fact that the Tiger defense has really stiffened up, and they have all their holes plugged against the Trojan rush. And it's a matter of time, I think, before Rigby starts throwing the ball against Idaho Falls. Of course, they want to move the ball on the ground if they can and eat up time. Meanwhile, the Tigers watch Rigby call timeout. So we'll do the same with 10:36 to play in the game. It's Rigby 18 and Idaho Falls 13. Did I say 18-13 in favor of Rigby? It is in truth 18-15 in favor of Rigby. Trojans have the ball, and really the Tiger defense has done a heck of a job on the Trojans here in the second half.
Well, Jim, in the first half, Rigby had 253 yards in offense here in the third quarter, and the first 90 seconds of the fourth quarter, Idaho Falls has held Rigby to just 5 yards in offense.
Director Bill Jewell has instructed us to point out that all of the scoring has taken place in the second quarter of this contest. No points in the first period and so far, and that there were none in the third.
It's second and long for Rigby. Here's a pitch back. Going to be a halfback pass. Here's one thrown downfield. This is intercepted by Scott Warren at the 25 of the Tigers. There will be no run back. It was kind of a sidearm pass. It was thrown by Kazir downfield, and Scott Warren jumped in front of the intended receiver, so the Tigers give the ball to Rigby on the INT, and Rigby returns a favor, and Idaho Falls will take over first down from their own 50.
10:29 left to play in the ball game, and let's see if Idaho Falls can get on the scoreboard. Hillcrest now leads Pocatello 14-7, and late in the ball game, it's still Skyline 13, Madison 6, with about 3 or 4 seconds left to go. Skyline trying to bounce back, get back into the win column. Brady Lee takes the snap from Charter, rolls to the far side. Lee has the football. He's going to keep it. He's not going to go anywhere. Jesse Thomas, Jeremy Majera, and the Rigby defense hit Brady Lee for a gain of a couple.
Brady Lee hit behind the line of scrimmage, but he drug the two tacklers you indicated for 2 more yards, and it goes up to about the 27.
Second down, we'll call it 8. Tigers trail 18-15. Idaho Falls ranked number 5 in the state. A1 Division 1 this week, taking on a winless Rigby team.
And lo and behold, after three-plus quarters, Rigby leads by three. Kevin Tenike, Mark Ellison in the backfield. Hursley and Hammond both wide to the left, and now a flag has been thrown as somebody lined up in the neutral zone against Idaho Falls, and now it's second down and 13. 10 minutes to play.
I mean, this whole high school football game is insane.
There's a little double reverse to Nate Hammond. Hammond has blockers out in front. Lee gives him a nice block, and Hammond is going to get maybe a couple of yards. Great play. Jeremy Majera, the defensive end for Rigby. He was not fooled. He stayed at home on the double reverse and a gain of a couple. It'll ring up third and 12. As Nate Hammond on the double reverse, the flanker reversed, got just 1 yard. Big play here for the Tiger offense. Third down and 12. Big play for the Rigby defense as they hold on to a three-point lead.
Trying to get the feeling that Idaho Falls is searching for that big, big play somehow rather than just kind of bread and butter things with the Tenike and Ellison and the things that they usually do best.
Well, the Tigers came out to the line of scrimmage. Now they are called back as one of the Trojans with an equipment problem. Now that problem seems to be okayed, and we'll get back to football. Third down, 12. Line of scrimmage, the 23. Tigers need to take it to their own 35. Trips left, lone setback. It's Jack Klein. Nope, that's Jesse Collard in the backfield behind Brady Lee. Lee rolls to the near side, throws the middle screen to Kevin Tenike. Tenike breaks one tackle. He's not going to get the first down. He goes from the 23 to the 31 for a gain of 8. And that's going to be 4 yards short, and the Tiger punt team will go out again. Defense, the big key here in the second half. They've held Idaho Falls scoreless. Ryan Cook will punt for only the second time tonight. Cook's first punt traveled 33 yards.
And this is the defense that gave up 51 points to Madison last week.
Here's the snap. Cook gets it. It's a nice spiral kick. Yearsley calls for the fair catch. He fumbles the football, and Idaho Falls has it. The Tigers pick up the loose football on the football for Idaho Falls. It was Chris French. So Chris French, a senior linebacker with a big recovery, and Idaho Falls gets a break. They'll take over first and 10 at the Rigby 42-yard line. Trojan coaching staff are saying that the Tigers did not give the deep back Glenn Yearsley any room to catch the football, and boy, Rigby coaches are irate.
Well, one just threw his clipboard almost up into the stand saying that their intended receiver was interfered with and was not given an opportunity to catch the ball.
So Chris French picks up a big fumble for the Tigers, and Idaho Falls keeps possession at the Rigby 42-yard line. 8:30 left to go, and now timeout. Referee timeout.
And maybe
on. Not have to give the man calling the fair catch any room whatsoever as long as you don't touch him. Here's the handoff. Tenike on the misdirection play. Tenike is knocked off his feet after a gain of 6 or 7. Tackle made by Jeff Peterson, the inside linebacker. Tenike went from the Trojan 42 down to the 37, a gain of 5. It'll be second down and 5. Clock at 8:14 left to go in the ballgame. Final score from Rexburg, Skyline 13. Madison 6 of the Grizzlies back on the win column. That's nice to see. The Grizzly D gives up just 6 points tonight against a very potent Madison offense. Second and 5. Hand off Tenike across the left side. Tenike inside the 35 down to the 33 for a gain of 3 to bring up third down in the couple.
20 carries, 75 yards now for Kevin Tenike, and it's kind of good to see the Tigers going back to what they can do best right now. They're not trying to fancy Dan Rigby any way, shape, or form, but rather they're doing the things they can do best, and that is give the ball to Kevin Tenike, and don't be surprised to see Brady Lee on a keeper play not too long from now, maybe a little dish off to Ellison. That's the way the Tigers can effectively get the ball down the field.
Third down and 2, 7 minutes left to go in the ballgame, 7:15. Here's the snap. It's handed off to Tenike. Tenike bounces to the outside. He's going to have the first down and right close to it. Great second effort by Kevin Tenike. Tackle made by Jake Erickson. And let's see where the Tigers got a friendly spot on the football. Tenike needed a couple. It looks like he picked up 2.5 from where we sit, and it will be a Tiger first and 10. Great second effort by the junior tailback, Kevin Tenike. He was hit right around the line of scrimmage, kept the feet pumping, and picked up the yardage. Clock set 7 minutes to play. Rigby 18, Idaho Falls 15, fourth quarter. Tigers trying to avoid a big upset. Up the middle, Tenite goes nowhere. It is Kenny Koster in on the stop, along with Denton Anderson. A gain of one, second down and nine. Well, whatever the outcome, just a great performance by the Rigby Trojans tonight.
Hey, frankly, a not too shabby performance by Idaho Falls. They fell behind by an 18-7 score, and the Tigers have battled back. They've been supportive on defense here in the second half, and they're up against a pretty tough and fired-up Rigby defense.
High formation, Lee on the quarterback keeper, rolls to the near side, breaks one tackle. He's inside the 30. Butts head with Michael Randall. He's down to the 25 for a gain of six. Brady Lee running like a fullback that time, just lowered his shoulder and ran into the quarterback, Michael Randall. It'll bring up a third and three.
And what a great run by Brady Lee that time, because there's really nothing there, and yet he made a whole lot of it out of nothing, and he puts Idaho Falls in good shape. The Tigers have two downs to make 3 yards as they now are in that so-called red zone.
Brady Lee, 10 carries, 64 yards tonight. Nate Hammond goes wide, right to the near side. It's Hursley, lone set. Back is Ellison, the fullback, on third and three. Lee takes the snap. Brady wants to throw. Throws an out pass to Hursley inside the 20. He's tackled at the 19. That'll be a gain of six and another Tiger first and 10. The Tigers 16, first down of the ball game. First and 10, Idaho Falls at the Trojan 19. The clock stopped with 5:38 left to go in the ball game.
Positively, the last play you'd look for was third down and short and in two down territory. So what did the Tigers do? They throw something out into the flat.
We have never, ever tried to guess what Jack Klein will do. He always fouls us up, and a good call right there on third and short. Hand off up the middle, Tenike. Tenike is inside the 15. He's down to the 12. That'll be a gain of about six or seven. Good blocking up the middle by Charter, Longhurst, and also Tyler Wright, the two guards and the center, respectively. A gain of six for Tenike. Second down and four. At the 13, the Tigers need to get it just inside the Trojan 10-yard line. The clock is now under 5 minutes to play. It's been a scoreless second half at Raston, but the Tigers try to change all of that. Lee hands the ball to Tenike. Tenike bounces outside. He's inside the 10, down to the 5-yard line for a first and 10. Element Hancock made the stop. This time, Tenike went on the right side behind Big Kevin Longhurst and Aaron Nelson. A gain of eight, and it's first and goal from the 5-yard line. 4:44 left to go in quarter number four. Rigby 18, Idaho Falls 15.
24 carries, 91 yards now for Kevin Tenike. And, of course, this is the big time for Idaho Falls right here. The clock is running down. The Tigers are behind, but now it's first and goal for them.
The line of scrimmage, the Trojan is six. Trips left, and now a flag has been thrown. Delay of game against Idaho Falls. The Tigers took too much time getting a play from the sideline, so we first and goal from the 11.
Just a horrible time to have that penalty called against Idaho Falls.
Eighth penalty against the Trojans. Brady Lee to Brian Hursley from the 11 down to the 2. It'll be second and goal from the 2. Clock stopped, 4:19 left to play in the ball game. This drive began at the Rigby 42-yard line following the bobbled punt. Chris French, again, he was the Tiger that recovered the loose football. That set up what could be the game-winning drive. Second and goal. Tigers come out in the power eye set. Tenike, the deep back in the power eye. He'll get the handoff. Tenike follows his blockers. Touchdown, Idaho Falls. Charter, Kevin Longhurst, Aaron Nelson, the center right guard, right tackle, along with the two fullbacks, Jack Klein and Mark Ellison. For Kevin Tenike, his third touchdown of the season. And now Dave Monk on for the PAT. It's 21-18. And this point after will give the Tigers a four-point lead if it is successful. Tiger touchdown drive, 11 plays. It took them a while, but they got it in, 42 yards. Tenike from 2 yards out. Here's the snap. The placement is down. The kick is up, and the kick is no good. So the point after, no good, and Rigby is still within a field goal of tying this thing up. 4:16 left. At the 40-yard line, back deep, Glenn Yearsley stands at his 5, but on every kickoff tonight, the Tigers have squib-kicked it. And let's see if they will continue that trend. 4:16 4:16 left to play. A lot of time for Ty Shippett and the Rigby offense. Although the Tiger D has been very, very stingy here in the second half. Dave Monk awaits the referee's whistle. Monk's going to approach the football. Here's the kickoff. He kicks it this time straight up. It's going to go to Jake Erickson at the 14-yard line. Erickson to the 20. He's tackled at the 27-yard line. In on the stop was Mike Bundy for Idaho Falls. And Rigby, first and 10 at the 28-yard line. Ty Shippen go back upstairs again. Shippen is 0-for-3 passing here in the second half after going 8-for-11 in the first half. He drops straight back. 3, 4, 5 steps. Here's a pass out into the flat. It's complete to Kazir, who grabbed it at the 30-yard line. He goes out of bounds immediately, about 2 yards upfield. Jake Griffin was right there to make sure he went no further. We'll call it a gain of 3. It'll bring up second down and 7. So Shippen is going to throw the football, and the clock stops with 3:59 to play. 21-18 the score. The Tigers have the lead over the Trojans. Earlier, Highland beat Bonneville 46-6. Hillcrest leading Pocatello 14-7 last we heard. Now here's Shippen rolling to his right. Here's a pass incomplete. It was intended for Jordan Crane, and Crane couldn't make the catch at the 35-yard line. Scott Warren was there to make sure that he did not. And 6 seconds went off the clock on that pass incompletion. It'll bring up third down and 7. The football at the Rigby 31. Trojans trailed by 3, 21-18. Skyline defeated Madison by a 13-6 score. So this is the only thing going on right now in the area, although Hillcrest and Pokey having had it down at the W Dome in Pocatello. Down play Rigby, 3rd and 7. Shippen drops straight back. The blitz was on, and no receiver there to catch the football. Shippen had to unload. Shippen was on Shippen like a glove, and Pat Owens then gave him a big kiss from behind. So Shippen had to get rid of the ball in a hurry, and the Trojans did pick up the blitz that time. Shippen did unload the ball. There was just no receiver to turn around and catch it.
And the Trojans will go for it on 4th and 7 from the 31 of the Rigby's 31-yard line.
3:39 to play as the clock is stopped. 21-18 to score.
This could be the game that the Tigers hold here.
Rigby lines up with 2 wide receivers on the right side. Here's the play. Straight drop. Here's the pass by Shippen, and this is intercepted by Idaho Falls Nate Hammond. As the receivers ran wrong patterns or something, Hammond was able to step in front of Brandon Andrews and pick it off. Mike Jensen puts big pressure on Ty Shippen and maybe made him throw the ball before he wanted to. And so Idaho Falls has held. There's 3.5 minutes to go in the game. The Tigers are leading by a 21-18 score, and Idaho Falls now has possession of the ball at the Rigby 42.
Mike Jensen's pass rush on Ty Shippen forced that interception. The 3rd INT for the Tiger defense tonight.
Tiger D arrived in the second half.
Brady Lee hands the ball to Tenike. Kevin Tenike, a lot of room. He's inside the 30, 35, or right at the 35 for a gain of 7. Again, great blocking on the Tiger right side by Longhurst and Nelson, along with tight end Paul Martin.
And so Kevin Tenike now an even 100 yards for the game, but has taken him 26 carries to do so.
Kevin has been the workhorse for the Tigers tonight. 26 carries and even 100 yards. The first time Kevin has reached the century mark this season.
Brady Lee has carried 10 times for 64.
Lee up under center, taking all the time he wants, looking at the sidelines, looking at Jack Klein, who is getting the time to now. The Tigers will get penalized for delay of game. 2:39 left to play in the fourth. It's Idaho Falls 21, Rigby 18. Brady Lee, now a flag is thrown by the line judge. And let's see, it'll be perhaps against Idaho Falls. That's the case. Another 5-yard penalty. That's the 10th flag against Idaho Falls tonight.
So Idaho Falls, in all probability, is going to win their 4th game against 1 loss on the year, and Rigby is going to lose their 5th consecutive. But as you've indicated, we have to give a lot of credit to Rigby in this contest tonight. And I give a lot of credit to Idaho Falls. They came back in the second half. They were flat when the game started. Rigby did some great things, but Idaho Falls sucked it up, and they've come back, and they've done what they had. to do.
Grady Lee is going to be sacked, and now he throws one away. That'll be illegal grounding. Intentional grounding is called on Grady Lee. Lee just threw it away to try to avoid the sack, and he got caught red-handed.
Some of the Idaho Falls coaches on the sidelines are pointing to a receiver downfield about 20 yards. I think the ref made a good look.
The Tigers call. Lee wants to throw. Lee wants to go down the middle and tip for Hursley. Incomplete. Nearly picked up by Hellman Hancock. And out comes the Tiger punt unit. Not a good series for Idaho Falls as they were flagged three times on the series.
You have to say that this is a very, very crucial punt for the Tigers here. A block and Rigby's back in, and a bad punt and Rigby's right back in this thing.
Bad snap, and we've seen that happen by the Tigers this year.
Yep. Once this game,
Jake Erickson will be the return man. Ryan Cook is the punter. He stands at his own 25-yard line. So that drive, boy, killed the Tigers. Minus 17 yards on the drive. Collared the snap. It's a high one, but it goes to Cook. Here's the kick by Ryan Cook. A high spiral. It's going to take an Idaho Falls bounce. Bounces at the 30, inside the 30, down to the 27-yard line. It'll be a 32-yard punt by Ryan Cook, and Rigby has a shot with 2:21 left to go in the ballgame. Tigers 21, Rigby 18.
3-point. 12-yard pickup, and the clock is stopped while they move the chains along. 2:07 to play in the game. 21-18 the score. Idaho Falls has the lead, but the Tigers defense going to hang on, and that time Rigby did indeed go over the middle with a pass play.
Only the second first down of the second half by Rigby. The first down came on a Tiger penalty.
Rigby has not been able to move the ball on the ground at all here in the second half. Shipping up under center. Here's the snap. Drops straight back. Takes a draw. Nope, it is a draw play. And the Tigers' Mike Jensen not fooled. Great defensive play. Jensen, the 200-pound senior. Defensive right end. It'll be a loss of about 7. A loss from the 37 all the way back to near the 30. And Rigby calls timeout. Rigby was trying to fool Idaho Falls as they ran the draw rather than throw the football, but it did not fool the 6'3", 200-pound senior Mike Jensen, who has been superlative on defense for the last four games. Timeout Rigby, 1:40-18. We'll take a break ourselves for half a minute. Third and make it second and 15. Rigby back to throw. Shippen looks downfield, throws fairly deep, and this one is incomplete. It was intended for Jordan Crane, and Brian Hursley put a heck of a hit on Jordan Crane as the ball got there and knocked it loose. Great defensive play by the 150-pound junior Ryan Hursley, who made an outstanding catch against Skyline last week and has made a couple of big catches in this game tonight. Ryan Hursley making himself known, and now it's third and long for Rigby.
Ryan Hursley leaves the Tigers in interceptions with 3. Big hit that time to avoid the pass completion by Rigby.
1:38 to play here in the game. 21-18. Tigers by 3. Shippen drops straight back. Throws down the middle. This one is caught. And on his way is Brian Andrews. He's up to the 50-yard line and finally tackled at about the 47. It was Brady Lee who finally made the tackle for the Tigers as Andrews caught the aerial. And it's a pickup of 20 yards for Rigby. And a first down of the Tiger 48. Clock stopped while the chains are moved along. 1:32 to go. Now the clock runs. Shippen ready to go. Drops straight back. Now rolls to his left. Has some time. Makes his throw. Great defensive play, Pat Owens. He knocked the ball down before it got to Brandon Andrews. He dove in front of the ball and knocked it down. It'll bring up second down and 10, Rigby. Clock stopped. 1:23 to play. And it'll be second and 10, Rigby from the Idaho Falls 48.
Jim, on that previous play, defense, if you will,
Jordan Bourne and Brady Lee, a couple of free safeties, are in the game for Rigby. Back to throw is Shippen. Now he's rolling left. Now he throws down the middle of the field. This one is in the air and almost intercepted by Hammond. It was knocked into the air by Nate Hammond, and then it was anybody's ball. There were 3 players with white shirts and about 4 with black shirts diving for the loose ball. I'll be a son of a gun if it didn't hit the turf and right in the middle of all of them.
Tigers, of course, rushing just 3 players, giving Shippen some time, but a good play by the Tigers secondary that time. Nate Hammond knocked it away.
It's a third and 10 play for Rigby. The ball at the Idaho Falls 48. 1:16 to play. Third and 10 for the Trojans. Tigers dropping eight people back. Shipman going to throw it. Does throw it. It's caught by Andrews, and he catches it for close to a first down. Pat Owens made the tackle somewhere around the 48, which will be a gain of 10. And we'll see if they're going to spot the football for the first down or if Rigby's going to have to run a play to get it. Now they're going to ask the chain gang to come on. And for what it's worth, Andrews had the first down, but then he tried to elude a tackle. Are calling their play as the chain gang is returning from the midfield and going back to the sideline, so Rigby will be all lined up.
This drive started at Trojan 27.
1:09 to play in the game, 21 Idaho Falls, 18 Rigby, but Rigby is now at Idaho Falls 39. Troy Shipman, the 175-pound senior quarterback, directing the attack. Running back Thomas and Kazir. Here's a pass out into the flat. It's dropped by Andrew at the 30-yard line, and the Tigers got a good break that time. Andrew was wide open at the 30, probably would have gotten five more yards and then maybe run out of bounds, but he started running before he caught the football. Plain and simple, incompleted forward pass. It'll be second down and 10 for the Trojans from the Tiger 39 with 1:02 to play in the contest.
Obviously, Brandon Andrews, the go-to guy for Ty Shipman here on this drive.
Mike Aranda, the leading receiver, has not been in this game offensively. Waiting for the play. Shipman is going to throw it. Has some time. Now the time is breaking down, and he throws the football in the neighborhood of DeBell. A flag was thrown. Jensen was the guy who got him as he was going down. He tried to unload the ball to DeBell. A flag was thrown. An intentional grounding, I think, is going to be called, and that'll be a good call.
Loss of 10 to make it a loss of 9 on the sack by Mike Jensen. That will hold up, and the penalty will go against Rigby. That'll send the Trojans back in their own territory.
And so Rigby must go from the 47 down to the 28, so they have a 25-yard distance to travel in two plays. Shipman is rolling to his right. He's throwing the ball deep, way deep. The receiver is there, but it's broken up by Brian Hursley. It was Jordan Crane, the intended receiver, and Hursley made the great defensive play for the Tigers to make sure there was no completion. The ball traveled 40 yards in the air, and now it's fourth down for Rigby, fourth and 25. They have the ball at their own 47, and as we indicated, they have to take it to the 29 of Idaho Falls. So this is the big play of the game right here for both the offense of Rigby and the defense of the Tigers. And you know what Rigby's going to do.
No draw play this time. It's Ty Shipman needs to get at least 25, 26 yards on this play.
And Jordan Bowen takes a few extra steps back. Tigers will rush three people and drop eight. Back to throw is Shipman. Back to throw. He does throw deep. Nobody home. And it's an incompleted pass at the 15. So the Tiger defense has held. And in all probability, the cake is in the oven for the Tigers now. So it'll be first down for Idaho Falls at the Rigby 47. Following four consecutive incompletions by Shipman. And, of course, the big play was the intentional grounding, but there was incompletions anyway. So the Tigers have the football, in all probability the victory. And with 43 seconds to go, I guess you know that Idaho Falls is just going to fall on the football and win this thing.
So the Tigers will escape Ramston Stadium with a very hard-fought win against a very, very tough Rigby Trojan team. Brady Lee takes the snap, falls back for a couple of yards loss, but that's no big deal. We might have one more play, and that'll do it. Well, it was in doubt until the final minute of the game. The winless Trojans gave the Tigers all they wanted and more tonight.
Congratulations to both teams on their efforts.
We have seen some great games here at Ramston this year, Jim. This is the fifth straight game the Tigers have played here at Ramston Stadium. And again, Brady Lee takes the snap, goes to one knee, and that'll be the final play of the game. So the Tigers, well, they escape with a three-point win. The clock is down to 4, 3, 2,